Okay, good morning to all of you. I welcomes to all in our lecture series of your mathematical physics. Today we are going to discuss about dielectric sphere in a uniform electric field. So this is the figure which is represents a dielectric sphere having the radius r placed in a uniform electric field, that is your E zero. So uniform electric field is here is E zero, and the dielectric material having the dielectric constant K, that is nothing but permittivity divided by permittivity of the free space, dielectric permittivity by dielectric permittivity of the free space, that we know, placed in a uniform electric field. And this things can be solved by using Laplace equation in the spherical polar coordinate system, that is your del square V r theta phi equal to 0. Here V is the potential that may be outside or inside. Suppose we are going to be consider P is the point where we have to find out, where we have to find out the potential. This is the point which is outside the dielectric material. Likewise, if we can consider a point, any point P, inside the dielectric material, for that we have to solve this Laplace equation. And whenever we are going to get V potential, by using V we can easily find out our electric field intensity at any point inside and outside. This is along ER, along ER the expression of electric field intensity, and with variation of theta this will be minus 1 by r del V by del theta, we can easily calculate. So our first work is we have to solve this differential equation, whatever we are already solved in our spherical polar coordinate system. By using spherical polar coordinate system, this equation, this Laplace equation already solved. So here it is written that previously we found, by solving this equation, previously we found the general solution of this equation number 1 is V r theta phi, here function. This r theta phi is the function of V. V r theta phi is equal to summation over n is equal to 1 to infinity n r to the power n plus b n r to the power minus n plus 1, bracket closed, p n m cos theta, here cos theta also is the function, not multiplication, cos theta is the function, into c m into e to the power plus or minus I m phi. Let it is equation number 2. But at a particular point, this is the important statement, that is at a particular point that may be inside of the dielectric or outside the dielectric material, V is always independent of azimuthal angle, that is your phi. So by considering m equal to 0 for this equation number 2, we can write, or the equation number 2 will be V r theta equal to, this term will be equal to approximately 1, because e to the power 0 will be 1. So cm will be the constant, will be multiplied with 1, we can consider as also 1. This term can be considered as 1. So the equation number 2 will be modified with V r theta is equal to summation over n is equal to 1 to infinity a n r to the power n plus b n r to the power minus n plus 1, bracket closed, b n p n p n cos theta. Let it is equation number 3. So here p n cos theta, we know that this is your Legendre polynomials, where p 0 cos theta equal to 1, because we know that p 0 x equal to 1, p 1 x equal to x, p 2 x equal to 1 by 2 3 x square minus 1. So here instead of x we have cos theta. So p 0 cos theta equal to 1, p 1 cos theta will be equal to cos theta, and p 2 cos theta will be equal to 1 by 2 3 cos square theta minus 1. Now the important thing is that here we have been considered that the V is independent of phi. this is somewhat important that we have to understand. Before that, I am going to somewhat explain how these electric field lines of forces are outside and inside. We know that for a conducting material, lines of force inside the dielectric material will be zero, but for a dielectric material, it will be present, it will be not zero, it will be present inside this material, because for a dielectric material, we can get only the polarization inside the dielectric material. Due to polarization, here suppose we applied a positive potential and this is the negative potential. In case of a dielectric material, we can get the polarization. Due to polarization net, we can get accumulation of charges at two sides of the dielectric material. This is your plus and this is your minus, this is your plus. Due to that, we can get a induced electric field EI, and suppose this is the applied electric field E0, but here EI is less than that of the E0, hence inside the dielectric material we can get the net electric field is E0 minus EI. So in case of dielectric material, we have the electric lines of forces. So hence the electric lines of forces outside the dielectric material will be like this, inside it is a uniform, then outside this will be like this. So this is another lines of force penetrated inside the dielectric material, goes like this and ejected like this. So this is another lines of force. So this is the lines of force, whatever we have inside and outside of a dielectric sphere. Now why in the V is independent of phi? This is the figure from where we can understand. See, suppose this is the dielectric sphere and you just imagine this is the half sphere, upper half of the sphere. So this is the base of the half sphere. Suppose we have to consider a point P is here. This P have variation with from the origin. This is your R and this angle is theta. Suppose this is your x axis, y axis and z axis. This is the point. So this is the variation of theta, this is the variation of R in case of polar coordinate system, and if we have to consider the projection from P to xy plane, this is your phi angle. Okay, now if this point is going to be revolved like this on the surface of the sphere, if this point is going to revolve, then the phi is going to be changed. If the phi is going to be changed, the charge, corresponding charge, which is influenced on this point, is not going to be changed. So the corresponding charge, which is influenced, this is your minus charge, this is your plus charge. So the corresponding charges which is influencing upon the point P, that is not going to be changed when this point is revolving around on the circumference of the surface, which changes the phi. So due to change of phi, we are not going to be change any type of influencing charges. What about the polarity? These are the minus, these are the plus charges. But if this point is going to be revolve on the circumference, only this charge is always be constant. This charge density always be constant. Only for that, with change of phi, your V is not going to be changed, and V is always independent of phi. Now, the equation number 2 will be, whenever we have to consider m equal 0, the equation number 2 will be this one, and this is your Legendre polynomial, and the value of the Legendre polynomials are this one. Now, this equation number 3 can be solved by considering the boundary conditions. You can see that in the equation number 3, many constants or coefficients that we have to evaluate. This is the an1 coefficient, bn, pn, that we are going to evaluate. So these coefficients can be evaluated by using boundary conditions. कितने समय है देखिल 10 मिनट. So I suggest that you have to write down the these things by pausing the video, because I have to erase to write down the preceding sections. But this here I am writing the all the equations whatever I am finding. The equation number 3 is required for further processing or further preceding our next derivations. So this here I am writing all the equations, but I have to erase all the things. So you have to pause the video and you have to write down the note. Now we have to consider the boundary conditions. The electric field is assumed to be E0 at large distance from dielectric sphere. Hence V out will be equal to E0 x, or this will be minus E0 r, this will be E0 minus E0 r cos theta as r tends to infinite. That means at very large distance your V out or potential. Here out means outside. How this we got this one? Because we know that E equal to minus del V by del X. That is your V equal to minus E into dx. So our last distance, suppose a dx is considered as x. So V equal to Ex. So here at large distance means from this is your dielectric sphere, and from this dielectric sphere at larger distance, this will be E0 into x along x axis if we are going to consider. So here it will be x for any point. Suppose this is a point which is make an theta with x axis. So its corresponding component, x component, can be written as minus E0 r cos theta. E0 r cos theta, because from here to here this is r. So if this point will be situated on the x axis, the theta will be 0, then it can be written as E0 x, whatever the distance from origin to that point. So in generalized, we have been written V out at the larger distance, potential at any outer point will be minus E0 x will be equal to minus E0 r cos theta as r tends to infinite. This is our first boundary condition. We have to go for the next boundary condition. Next boundary condition, that is your second I. For internal point that is r less than your radius, because we have been considered that the radius of this sphere is a. This figure I roughly drawn to understand the this boundary conditions, but you can understand from your main figure. For internal point, that is for r less than a, V is finite and is given by, as we discussed, that inside the dielectric material the electric lines of forces will be present, that means potential also present inside the dielectric material. So inside the dielectric material the V will be always finite, and it will be written in the form of V in, that means potential inside, in means inside, equal to AI into R cos theta, into R cos theta, into R cos theta. So here what is AI, I am going to explain. Wait, first you write what do you mean by AI, then I am going to explain. Here AI in bracket is the resultant, is the resultant electric field, is the resultant electric field, is the resultant electric field inside, inside the dielectric, inside the dielectric, which is the dimension of, which is the dimension of E0. That means this EI is equivalent to your applied electric field, means this AI has the physical meaning is a electric field intensity. So dimension of E0 depended on dielectric constant, dielectric constant K and dielectric constant K. AI will be evaluated by considering boundary condition. So in short I am writing boundary condition, but your note you have to write boundary condition. Here BC means boundary conditions. So here instead of BC you have to write boundary conditions. So come to the second boundary condition. Here second boundary condition we have been written that V in, potential inside the dielectric material, is equal to AI R cos theta. As we have a point outside, then it is E0 cos theta. So that point, suppose this point will be here, then this X component can be written as R cos theta, X component, or component can be written as R cos theta. But here AI, or if I am going to compare this equation and this equation, R cos theta is here, R cos theta is here, and here AI is equivalent to minus EI, equivalent to minus EI, or magnitude of AI is dimension of electric field intensity. But as we discussed, inside the dielectric material the induced electric field will be induced, and here external electric field is there, and resultant electric field inside this will be E0 minus EY, which is less than that of the applied electric field. So here we can found, or we can consider that this EI value will be always less than that of the E0, less than that of the E0. So here AI is considered as the resultant electric field inside the dielectric material, which is the dimension of E0, can be calculated by using the boundary conditions, and this AI is depends upon the dielectric constant of the material, because due to the dielectric constant will be changed to material to material, this AI also is going to be changed. So in simple we can write, or we can say that V out is नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड और अप्लाइड इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड आर कॉस थीटा ड्यू टू एक्स इक्वल टू एक्स कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय आर कॉस थीटा. इन दिस वे इन जनरल द डिस्टेंस कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय आर कॉस थीटा व्हेन थीटा विल बी जीरो दिस विल बी आर. सो इन जनरल इट कैन बी रिटन एज आर कॉस थीटा एंड ए आई इज द डायमेंशन ऑफ और इज इक्विवेलेंट टू योर इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी दैट वी आर गोइंग टू बी कैलकुलेट बाय यूजिंग बाउंड्री कंडीशंस. एंड हियर वन थिंग वी कैन से सी दैट सी हियर दिस इज योर आर कॉस थीटा वेट दिस इज योर आर ऑल्सो कॉस थीटा. सो व्हेन थीटा इक्वल जीरो दिस विल बी द आर. When theta will be 0, this will be also r. That means this r represents from 0 origin to inner point distance and this r here, this r represents from origin to outside point distance. Okay. So, at the end we can found that this value will be the combination of electric field intensity and also distance by using boundary condition. So here actually this will be the dimension of, you just change it, the resultant electric field inside, which is the dimension of E0 and distance. E0 and distance. So we can found that AI will be is the combination of EI and also some distance that we are going to be found out by using boundary condition. Now third boundary condition is that the tangential component, the tangential component of electric field, the tangential component of electric field across the interface, across the interface must be continuous, must be continuous on the surface of the sphere. So here the tangential component of electric field must be continuous on the surface of the sphere. So whatever the tangential component of the electric field at the surface, that has to be continuous. That means at r equal to a, outside will be equal to inside. The tangential component of electric field always be continuous across the interface of the, must be continuous, electric field across the interface must be continuous on the surface of the sphere. So on the surface of the sphere both the tangential components should be same. So mathematical what we can write, that is V out equal to V in at R equal to A. Now we can ask the question, here I written electric field but I represented this one is in the form of potential. No problem, because we know that V equal to E x. So xx can be cancelled out. So this dimension, so E out and E in into x, if I am going to write in this format, this will be represented also in this way. So V out will be equal to V in at the interface of the, at the interface of the sphere or on the surface of the sphere. Next, fourth boundary condition is that the normal component, the normal component, the normal component of electric displacement must be continuous. So wherever I am doing somewhat spelling mistake, you can correct by hearing the audio. Across the interface. So this is the basic two laws of our electrodynamics, that at the surface the tangential component of electric field is continuous, at the surface the normal component of electric displacement must be continuous. So what is the relationship between electric displacement and E? D equal to epsilon 0 E for the free space. So at the across the interface means at the surface. So at the surface, this is the boundary where we can say that this is the inner side, this is the outer side. So at this point here, D out equal to D in. So at this point, D out equal to D in. That is electric displacement means D. Okay. So D out equal to D in at R equal to A. So D out, D in, that means outside the sphere is the free space. So it will be written as epsilon 0, because we know that D is equal to epsilon 0 E for your free space, and D is equal to epsilon E for a dielectric material. Okay. So now for out, as outside is your free space, so it will be epsilon 0 E R out, okay, is equal to epsilon D, E R in. Okay, so that implies E R out equal to epsilon by epsilon 0 into E R in. At the beginning of our discussion, you can check your note, I have been written that K is nothing but, or dielectric constant is nothing but epsilon by epsilon 0. So instead of epsilon by epsilon 0, we can write dielectric constant K. So that implies ER out will be equal to K into ER in at R equal to A. This is our fourth boundary condition. So by using these four boundary conditions, this one and this one, second boundary condition, this is your third boundary condition, and this is your fourth boundary condition. By using these four boundary conditions, we have to find out the general solution, or we have to solve this equation number 3, and we have to find out an, bn, pn, etc. Okay. Here I suggest to all of you that you pause the video and write down the notes, and these equations I am writing here, this is our boundary conditions whatever we found here in this side. Here I am writing all the equations because it will be required in our further steps. So I suggest you have to pause the video and you have to write down the note. Now we have to use the boundary conditions for equation number 3 and we have to find out the generalized equation of this equation number 3 by using these boundary conditions. So patiently you have to watch this next steps. Now from boundary condition I, it can be found that now from the boundary condition I, that means here from the first boundary condition, it can be found that outside potential only contains cos theta terms, only contains cos theta terms. So the equation number 3 will be, will be what we can write, that will be B out R theta, because this is considered as outside potential. So this equation number 3 will be modified, contains only cos theta terms, okay. So V out R theta will be, it will be, first I am going to write by considering the summation term, then we have to put the values. So it will be A0 R to the power 0 plus B0 R to the power minus 1 into P0 cos theta plus A1 R to the power 1 plus B1 R to the power, if n will be 1 then it will be minus 2 P1 cos theta plus A2 and so on. Here A2 term I am not going to be considered, because it will be A2 R to the power 2 plus B2 R to the power minus 3 into P2 cos theta. We know that P2 cos theta is the higher order of the cos theta, because P2 cos theta we found, you just check previously, that it is 1 by 2 3 cos square theta minus 1. So only for that, beyond of this term, these terms A2, A3, A4, A5, these terms will contain higher order of cos theta. So hence these are not going to be considered, only this two term is going to be considered. So I am not going to write here, only these two terms we have to write. So that implies V out R theta will be A0 R to the power 0 plus B0 R to the power minus 1 into P0 cos theta is 1 plus this is A1 R plus B by R square I can write. P1 cos theta is nothing but is your cos theta. B1 by R square. This is B1 by R square. So here this is whole of P1 cos theta. So this is whole of cos theta. So systematically we can write that implies V out R theta will be equal to A0 plus B0 by R plus A1 R cos theta plus B1 by R square cos theta. Let this is our equation number 4. This is our equation number 4, because this is our last equation number 3. So we found by considering boundary condition I, we found this one is our equation number 4. Okay. Now, the normal, now for internal points, the potential should not be include 1 by R. Then, for internal points means the points which are going to be considered inside the sphere, internal points means inside the sphere. Then for internal points means points which is inside the sphere, the potential, the potential should not include, one by R term, because as R equal to 0, V tends to infinite, which is not possible. What this sentence told, that suppose we are going to consider the any internal point, for this internal point the potential should not contain 1 by R term. Because why? If R tends to 0, means at the center, if we are going to consider this term at the center, V will be how much? 1 by 0 will be infinite, which is not possible. So in case of internal potential, whenever we are going to be consider internal potential, for this case 1 by R term should not be accepted. So that V in will be equal to AI R cos theta, which is also your boundary condition. What? Boundary condition 2. In case of boundary condition also, we have been written before that this is AI R cos theta. Here in this expression we could not found any 1 by R term. Why we could not found any 1 by R term? Because internal point means we can consider at the center. At the center, if we are going to consider, and if this term is contains any 1 by R term, then at the center it will be infinite, or V in will be infinite, which not to be acceptable. So hence V in will be AI R cos theta. Let it is your equation number equation number 5. A0 B0 A1 B1 and AI are constants. which are evaluated by considering boundary conditions. Boundary condition. See, here I am writing for boundary condition BC, but in your note you have to write boundary conditions. By applying boundary conditions, that is I, 2I, 3I, 4I, we can evaluate A0, V0, A1, B1, and here AI. I suggest pause the video and write down the note. I am going. So here by mistakenly I have written n equal to 1 to infinity. You just correct it in your note. That will be n equal to 0 to infinity. Okay, n equal to 0 to infinity. And here we got two equations, 4 and 5. Next we have to go forward. Now considering boundary condition 1. Now considering boundary condition 1. Now considering boundary condition 1 means I. That is I. And equation number 4. We get for r tends to infinite, for r tends to infinite, this is your equation number 4 represents v out. So at r tends to infinite, what will be the value? v out r theta will be equal to dash when r tends to infinity. Already we found that is in your boundary condition, this one. So this is minus e0 r cos theta, r tends to infinite. This is your belongs to r tends to infinite in case of boundary condition. V out equal to minus e0 r cos theta will be when r tends to infinite. And we have to consider equation number 4, that is this one. Then this V out, by considering equation number 4, V out will be A0, this value V0 by infinite will be 0 plus 0 plus A1 R cos theta plus 0. From equation number 4. So these two equations can be equate. We can found that implies minus e0 r cos theta is equal to a0 plus a1 r cos theta, this much only. This is your equation number 6. This is your equation number 6. By comparing LHS and RHS of equation number 6, we get A0 equal to 0. This is your equation number 7. And A1 equal to minus E0, that is your equation number 8. Hence equation number 4 will be, equation number 4 means this one, will be, that will be your V out. Again, I am not writing the r theta. This is always out means belongs to r theta. Okay, you can write, no problem. R theta equal to B0 by R minus E0 R cos theta plus B1 by R square cos theta. Let this is your equation number 9. Let this is your equation number 9. Okay. Now we have to consider boundary condition third eye by considering. Now, by considering boundary condition third eye means V out equal to V in at R equal to A. That is V out equal to V in at R equal to A. R equal to A. What we can found? V out value we found in equation number 9. V in we can found here from equation number 5. So now we have to apply the boundary condition third on equation number 5 and 9. That means at R equal to A, equation number 5 will be equal to R equal to A, equation number 9. Directly I am writing that implies AI, here I have to put A cos theta will be equal to B0 by A minus E naught A cos theta plus B1 by A cos theta or systematically I can write that implies AI A cos theta will be equal to B0 by A plus B1 by A square minus A E0 into cos theta. Let it is your equation number 10. Now, comparing LHS and RHS of equation number 10. Now, comparing LHS and RHS of equation number 10. We can found that B0 equal to 0. B0 equal to 0. Let this is your equation number 11 and AI A equal to B1 by A square. Just comparing the coefficients of this left side and left hand side minus A E0. Or that implies we can write AI equal to how much? Equal to I can write E0 minus E0 plus B1 by AQ. Let this is your equation number 12. Now the equation number 9. See, in your equation number 9, here B0 is unknown, B1 is also unknown. After solving this equation number 10, we found V0 value, right? Now we have to put the V0 value in our general equation. The equation number 9 is modified to. Now the equation number 9, I have to write by the red. Now equation number 9 is modified, modified to what it will be out. See, again, I am not writing r theta, which is function of v out, okay? So only I am writing v out means it is function of r and theta. So v out will be equal to b0 is the value is 0, so this term will be 0. So directly I have to write minus e naught r cos theta plus b1 by r square cos theta. This is your equation number 13. Here this is our general solution. This is our general solution. By using boundary conditions we are evaluating the constants. So you can see that using boundary condition I, we evaluated a0 and a1. We have substituted in equation number 4 and then we found the modified equation. In this equation b0 is unknown, b1 is unknown. Then we applied the boundary condition third and we found b0 equal to 0 and ai is this much. So by substituting b0 value again in this equation number 9, the modified equation is this one, okay? Now b1 also we are going to be found out by using boundary condition. So general equation, initially the general equation is your equation number 4. See, general equation is equation number 4. In this equation number 4, a0, b0, a1, b1 or are all knowns is going to be evaluated by using boundary conditions. 8, we have been evaluated a0 value, a1 value, b0 value. Now b1 we have to evaluate, ai also we have to evaluate, ai and b1 c is unknown, that we are going to be also evaluate also by using boundary condition. Now here you just write. Now ai and our rest two things we have to evaluate, ai and b1. Ai and b1 will be evaluated by using boundary condition IV, by using boundary condition IV. So I suggest pause the video and write down this much because I have to erase to proceeding further. So here this side is filled with equations up to equation number 12. So I started to write the extra equations here. So equation number 13, we found that v out equal to e0 r cos theta plus b1 by r square cos theta. So this much I have to erase. Then we have to use the boundary condition, that is your IV, to find out AI and BI. That is the boundary condition IV. We know that the boundary condition, according to boundary condition IV, what we know, that is ER out equal to K into ER, K into ER in at R equal to A, at R equal to A, at R equal to A. So now so this, by using this one we have to find out the AI and BI, B1. Before that we have to find out the ER value outside and inside. Without finding the ER value, we could not apply this boundary condition because we have the value of potential only. This is our outer potential and this is the general equation of inner potential, right? So by using V in and V out, first we have to find out E out and E in, okay? Now, ER out. Now, ER out will be equal to how much we can write minus del V out by del R. That means we can write del by del R of V out. What is the value of V out? By using equation number 13. We have to use the equation number 13 value. Minus E naught R cos theta plus B1 by R square into cos theta. So the value will be, that implies E R out will be equal to this will be how much? Minus and minus plus E naught cos theta plus minus. See, by considering 1 by R square derivative, 1 by R square derivative, del by del R of 1 by R square, this will be minus 1 by R to the power 4 into 2R. That will be minus 2 by R cube. So derivative of the differentiation of 1 by R square, we can found minus 2 by R cube. So here minus 2 by R cube, here is minus is there. So plus 2 by R cube, B1 is there. So I can write 2 B1 by R cube into cos theta. Let it is our equation number 14. Let it is our equation number 14. As we got here, we got VER out. What is required for this one? Okay. So now we have to find out E R in. For this equation, for using this equation, we need ER out and ER in. So ER in will be equal to how much? Minus del V in by del R. So is equal to minus del by del R of V in. AI R cos theta. So that implies ER in will be equal to minus AI cos theta. Let it is your equation number 15. Now from equation number 14 and 15, we found ER out and ER in, which is required for this equation, for this boundary condition. Now we have to use this one, this boundary condition. Now again you just write, no problem. Now considering boundary condition IV for considering boundary condition IV using equation 14 and 15, we get, that means this one, this boundary condition we have to use, we get what? We can get B out at R equal to A will be equal to ER out at R equal to A equal to K into ER in at R equal to A. What we can write? This will be direct, I am writing E naught cos theta for this equation I have to put r equal to a e naught cos theta plus 2 b1 by a cube into cos theta will be equal to k into minus here minus ai cos theta. Okay, from equation number 15 we found this one. This is the boundary condition. You just write, I not written. Again you can write, no problem. No problem. Here in your note you keep it. That is your er out equal to k into er. Keep it in your note, no problem. So by solving this, what we can found? We can found, see, E naught plus 2B1 by AQ into, that implies into cos theta will be equal to minus K AI cos theta. Okay, cos theta got cancelled. That implies we found minus k I is equal to E0 plus 2B1 by AQ, 2B1 by AQ. Yes or no? Now we have to use the equation number 12. Now use equation number 12. The equation number 12, where it is equation number here. The equation number 12 is nothing but AI equal to minus E0 plus B1 by AQ. So there, instead of AI, I have to put this much value. That means minus K into, instead of AI, means equation number 12, I have to put minus E0 minus E0 plus B1 by AQ is equal to E0 plus 2B1 by AQ. Again, I suggest you just pause the video and write down the note. Okay, so here that implies K E0 minus minus K E0. This E0 take to the LHS minus E0 is equal to 2 B1 by AQ. This is minus B1 by AQ will be moved to right side. It will be plus K B1 by AQ. By further simplification, we can write that implies this one can be right. E0 can be taken outside K minus 1 equal to B1 by AQ can be take common from this two term. We can write K plus 2. Yes or no? K plus 2. So that implies B1 we got K minus 1 by K plus 2 into E0 into AQ. In this way we found B1. This is your equation number 16. So now my board is filled up, so I have to write down the next. This is the 13 equation, 13, 14, 15, 16. I am writing the equations. Pause the video, you have to write down up to this much. So here up to equation number 16 we derived. So here I am writing for myself that I have to do the next steps. You should not be right. You have to direct write in your note. Okay, up to 16, we found B1 equal to K1 by K minus 1 by K plus 2 into E0 into AQ. Now we have to put this value in equation number 12. What we can get? Now, put equation number 16 in equation number 12. We get what we can get AI. This is our equation number 12. So AI will be equal to minus E0 plus 1 by AQ into B1. We found this one. That means your K minus 1 by K plus 2 into E0 into AQ. That means AY will be equal to minus E0 plus this AQ got cancelled. We found K minus 1 by K plus 2. K minus 1 by K plus 2 into E0. That implies AI will be equal to E0 can be taken outside. Minus E0 will be equal to 1 minus K minus 1 by K minus 1 by K plus 2. Again, by further solving, that implies AI equal to, it will be, can be written as E0 into this minus I multiplied, K minus 1 by K plus 2. Listen, I am deriving all the steps, but in your exam you should not be deriving. You have to direct, just put the 16 equation number 12 and last expression you have to write, okay? Yes, you have to remember. So E0, K minus 1 by K plus 2 minus 1. So that implies AI will be equal to E0 into K minus 1 minus K plus minus K, it will be minus 2 divided by K plus 2. So that implies AI equal to minus 3 E0 by K plus 2. This is your equation number 17. So I suggest you have to practice and try to remember this value, or you can without solving, you can solve these things in your rough with a speed manner, and you can write this last expression in your exam. No need to write all the steps. Okay. Next, this is your equation number 17. Now we have to use the equation number 16 and 17, the expression V out, the final expression V out means equation number 13 will be, sorry, V out will be. Now, using 16 and 17, the expression of V out and V in will be, that means V out we found, last expression is your equation number 13, and V in is your this one AI R cos theta. So here AI value we found this one, we have to put there, and B1 value this one we have to put in this equation number 13. We can found V out and V in. Hence, hence equation number 13 and 5 is your equation number V in. 5 will be in bracket, you just write this much. So V out will be equal to how much? E naught R cos theta plus, that is your, this is your equation number 13, this is your equation number 13, and in this equation number 13 we have to put B1 value. So whenever we are going to put B1 value, it will be, B1 is this much, that is your 1 by R square into K minus 1 by K plus 2 into E naught into AQ into cos theta. Okay, so with simplification manner you can write this K by K minus 1 by K plus 1, this R square you just write here, it will be AQ by R square or RQ, this is R square, AQ by R square into cos theta. Let this is your equation number 18, let this is your equation number 18, this is your equation number 18. Similarly, from equation number 5, from equation number 5, B in will be equal to, here AI is going to be substituted over here. Okay, it will be how much? Minus 3 E naught by K plus 2 into R cos theta, into R cos theta. It is your equation number 19. It is your equation number 19. How charge? How do you check the R cos? Now, here we found equation number 18, the potential outside, potential inside. We can found that this is your general expression in which there is no unknown parameters. All the unknown parameters we have been derived by using boundary conditions. This is your general expression of V out and V in. By using these two, we can find out the electric field expressions. So put the heading of electric field expressions. Electric field expression. Expression for electric. Expression for electric field. Expression for electric field. So first we have to consider for outside. So it will be ER out will be how much? Del V out by del R will be equal to minus del by del R of minus del by del R of minus E0 R cos theta plus K minus 1 by के प्लस टू इंटू इंटू ई जीरो ए क्यू बाय आर स्क्वायर इंटू कॉस थीटा. सो दैट इम्प्लाइज ई आर आउट विल बी इक्वल टू ई जीरो कॉस थीटा हियर डेरिवेटिव विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू आर माइनस माइनस प्लस देन प्लस वन बाय आर स्क्वायर डेरिवेटिव विल बी हाउ मच टू बाय आर क्यू माइनस टू बाय आर क्यू माइनस हियर अगेन माइनस विल बी प्लस इट विल बी टू ई जीरो ए क्यू बाय आर क्यू इंटू के माइनस वन बाय के प्लस टू इंटू कॉस थीटा. सो सिस्टमैटिकली आई एम राइटिंग ई आर आउट विल बी इक्वल टू ई जीरो इंटू इंटू वन प्लस के माइनस वन बाय के प्लस टू इंटू टू ए क्यू बाय आर क्यू इंटू कॉस थीटा लेट इट इज योर इक्वेशन नंबर टू लेट इट इज योर इक्वेशन नंबर टू लेट इट इज योर इक्वेशन नंबर 20. नाउ लेट इट इज योर इक्वेशन नंबर 20. सो दिस थिंग्स नाउ नॉट रिक्वायर्ड ओनली दिस टू इक्वेशंस आर रिक्वायर्ड. सो नाउ लाइक ई आर आउट वी कैन फाउंड आउट ई आर सॉरी ई थीटा आउट ई आर आउट एलोंग आर ई आर आउट विथ फंक्शन ऑफ थीटा एलोंग थीटा विल बी माइनस वन बाय आर डेल थीटा ऑफ दिस मच दैट विल बी माइनस ई जीरो आर कॉस थीटा के माइनस वन बाय के प्लस टू इंटू ई नॉट ए क्यू बाय आर स्क्वायर कॉस थीटा. सो दैट इम्प्लाइज ई थीटा आउट विल बी इक्वल टू हाउ मच इट विल बी दिस इज माइनस एंड माइनस प्लस डेल थीटा डेरिवेटिव कॉस थीटा विल बी माइनस साइन थीटा आर आर गॉट कैंसिल सो इट विल माइनस ई जीरो साइन थीटा प्लस हियर कॉस थीटा डेरिवेटिव विल बी माइनस अगेन हियर इट इज माइनस सो इट विल बी प्लस के वन बाय के माइनस वन बाय के प्लस टू इंटू ई जीरो ए क्यू बाय आर इंटू आर स्क्वायर विल बी आर क्यू इंटू कॉस थीटा. सो इन सिस्टमैटिक वी कैन राइट ई थीटा आउट विल बी इक्वल टू ये दिस इज आर स्क्वायर विल बी आर क्यू. इन सिस्टमैटिक मैनर वी कैन राइट ई जीरो इंटू वन प्लस के माइनस वन बाय के प्लस टू इंटू टू टू ए क्यू सॉरी आई जस्ट रिटन मिस्टेकली दिस विल बी माइनस ई जीरो इंटू वन माइनस के माइनस वन बाय के प्लस टू इंटू ए क्यू बाय आर क्यू इंटू साइन थीटा एक्चुअली हियर आई डोंट मिस्टेक कॉस थीटा डेरिवेटिव ऑफ साइन थीटा ओके साइन थीटा. सो दिस इज योर इक्वेशन नंबर 21. इन दिस वे वी फाउंड द ई आर आउट एंड along r and along theta. Now we have to find out for inside for inside ER in and ER theta. Pause the video and write down the note up to this much. Exactly in this way, by using this one, we have to find out ER in and E theta in. I am going to erase this much. Next, for inside, what it will be? For inside, how much it will be? See, it will be ER in means minus del B IN by del R. That implies that equal to minus del by del R of B in is how much? Minus 3 E naught by K plus 2 into R cos theta will be equal to ER in equal to will be how much with respect to derivative with respect to R? It will be 1, this is minus 3 E naught by K plus 2 into cos theta. Let it is your equation number 22. Now, similarly, we have to find out E theta in. Similarly, we have to find out E theta in will be equal to minus 1 by R del by del theta of V in. That means 1 by R into del by del theta of B in. That is minus 3 E0 minus 3 E0 by K plus 2. 3 E0 by K plus 2 into R cos theta. So that implies E theta in will be equal to how much? This R got cancelled. Derivative of cos theta will be minus sin theta. Minus here minus plus, again it will be minus. So at last we can get 3 E naught by K plus 2 into sin theta. That is your equation number 23. So from equation number 23, 22, 21 and 20. 21 and 20 I already erased. You can check your note. 23, 22, 21 and 20 represents the electric field intensity outside and inside with the function of R and theta. So this is the derivation of the dielectric sphere whenever we have to put in a uniform electric field by using Laplace equation. I suggest write down the note perfectly, watch the video carefully, and if any doubt, you can discuss. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.